What's up, dudes, and what is up, beautiful ladies out there? Brian here, and in this video, we're going to go over quarterback or passer rating, how it's calculated, and some of the pros and cons to it. All right, let's roll. So, passer rating in the NFL is on a scale from 0 to 158.3, and the five variables that it looks at are passing attempts, completions, passing yards, passing touchdowns, and interceptions thrown. The formula for passer rating is passer rating equals the quantity completions divided by attempts minus 0.3 times 5 plus the quantity passing yards divided by attempts minus 3 times 0.25 plus the quantity passing touchdowns divided by attempts times 20 plus the quantity 2.375 minus interceptions divided by attempts times 25. Take that result and divide it by 6 and then multiply by 100. To make this a little easier, we're going to shorten the equation to A plus B plus C plus D divided by 6 times 100, with A, B, C, and D being separate equations, with A equaling the first quantity, completions divided by attempts, minus 0.3 times 5. B equals the second quantity, passing yards divided by attempts, minus 3 times 0.25. C equals the third quantity, passing touchdowns divided by attempts times 20, and D, the fourth quantity, equals 2.375 minus interceptions divided by attempts times 25. So if we look into these equations, they're all probably stats that you've heard of before, as we have completion percentage in equation A, yards per attempt in equation B, touchdown percentage is in equation C, and interception percentage is in equation D. These other numeric values in these equations are used to scale each of the equations to be between 0 and 2.375, with 1.0 in any of the equations being average. So if a quarterback threw 2 touchdowns in 40 attempts, using equation C, we would calculate a result of 1. So in this category, he would be considered average for this performance. In finding the averages in all 4 of the equations, for equation A, which is based on completion percentage, a 50% completion rate results in a 1 in the equation. So 50% is considered average. In equation B, which is based on yards per attempt, 7 yards per attempt results in a 1. So 7 yards per attempt is considered average. In equation C, which is based on touchdowns per attempt, 5% results in a 1. So 1 touchdown thrown every 20 pass attempts is considered average. And in equation D, which is based on interception percentage, about 5.2 to 5.5% interception percentage results in a 1. So 1 interception for every 18 to 19 pass attempts is considered average. So realistically, the stats for a quarterback to have an almost perfectly average game is 18 completions, 36 pass attempts, 252 yards, 2 passing touchdowns, and 2 interceptions. I've done all the calculations on the screen, and this results in a passer rating of 68.29. And if we plug in 1s for all the variables in the main equation, the result is 66.67 as a completely average performance. There are 2 rules in regards to these 4 equations. If any of these equations results in a number greater than 2.375, it's set to 2.375. And if it results in a negative number, it's set to 0. So, for example, to reach the upper number of 2.375 in equation A, a quarterback would have to have a completion percentage of 77.5, which, for example, would be 31 completions in 40 attempts in a game. So any completion percentage greater than 77.5 would result in a number higher than 2.375. But for the main equation, you would plug in 2.375. And to get a 0 result in equation A, a quarterback would have to have a 30% completion percentage. For example, 9 completions in 30 attempts. Anything less than 30% would result in a negative number for equation A. So in this case, equation A would be set to 0. To reach the upper number of 2.375 for equation B, a quarterback would have to have 12.5 yards per pass attempt. For example, 375 passing yards on 30 attempts. Plug that into equation B, and it results in 2.375, as you see on the screen. Anything greater than 12.5 yards per pass attempt results in a number greater than 2.375. And in that case, you would plug in 2.375 for the main equation. In equation B, 3 yards per pass attempts would give a result of 0. So say 90 yards on 30 attempts. And anything less than 3 yards per attempt would give a negative number. So again, the result in equation B would be set to 0. To reach the upper number of 2.375 for equation C, a quarterback would have to have a touchdown percentage of 11.87%. which is about one passing touchdown for every 8.42 pass attempts. So if a quarterback threw 3 touchdowns and 25 pass attempts, this would result in equation C equaling 2.4. And in that case, you would plug in 2.375 for the main equation. For equation C, 0 passing touchdowns results in a 0 for the equation. And it's impossible to get a negative result for equation C because you can't have a negative number of touchdown passes. To reach the upper number of 2.375 for equation D, a quarterback would have to throw 0 interceptions, regardless of how many pass attempts, because 0 interceptions always results in equation D equaling 2.375. For equation D to result in 0, the quarterback's interception percentage would have to be 9.5%, which is about 1 interception every 10.53 pass attempts. So for example, if a quarterback had 3 interceptions and 31 pass attempts, which is an interception percentage of 9.68, equation D would give a result of negative 0.044, which again, in that case, you would plug in a 0 into the main equation for D. Now let's look at the best and worst ratings a quarterback can have. To have a total 0 rating, a quarterback must achieve a 0 in all 4 of the equations A through D. So less than 30% completion percentage, less than 3 yards per pass attempt, throw no touchdowns, and have an interception percentage higher than 9.5%. Nathan Peterman accomplished this feat in 2018, as he had 5 completions and 18 pass attempts for 24 passing yards, no touchdowns, and 2 interceptions. And some other notable quarterbacks have done this, as you see on the list here. A perfect rating is 158.3, with all of the variables A through D equaling 2.375 in the main equation. This feat was accomplished 5 times this past year, 2019, with Lamar Jackson doing it twice. As you see his numbers here, along with the numbers of the other quarterbacks to do it during the 2019 season. As of 2019, the best quarterback rating for a season was in 2011, when Aaron Rodgers had 343 completions in 502 pass attempts for 4,643 yards, 45 passing touchdowns, and 6 interceptions for a rating of 122.5. And as of the completion of the 2019 season, Rodgers is also the career leader in passer rating at 102.4, with the top 10 career leaders listed on the screen. Quarterback rating does have its pros and cons, my friends. It does take into account the main variables that show how good a quarterback is. And it also gives us a numeric scale to compare quarterbacks to one another. But it doesn't take into account some things like wide receiver drop passes or tipped interceptions or garbage time stats. Like at the end of a game, when a team's getting blown out and the defense is playing prevent and the quarterback's dropping back and just racking up huge numbers. All right, my friends, hopefully you got something out of this video. If not, if I just completely wasted your precious time, I do sincerely apologize. You can enact some immediate punishment upon me by, boom, pounding that thumbs down. It's all good. It's always good. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.